Welcome to new SavageJS App Podcast, and in this podcast it's all about the Angelfish web browser that you can install as Flatpak on SavageJS. If you don't know about Flatpaks, you can watch my last video where I explain how to install Flatpak support and how to install Angelfish. We want to configure Angelfish now just by simply going here, and we are overriding the scaling factor to 3 and overwriting the DPI as close as possible to 120. You can see it's a slider, it's a bit finicky because it's moving in one incremental steps. It would be nice if it would move in 5 or 10 incremental steps, or if you have the option to just enter the value that you want to have as override DPI, but it is what it is. We apply this configuration and then we have the option to just open up the web browser, and here you can see it's a modern web browsing engine, 479 points of 555 points, a nice web engine based on Qt Web Engine Blink, and you can see all the supported stuff in here. What we want to change is the navigation bar at the bottom. As you can see here, it has a menu bar, it has a tab button, and it has a sub menu. And we want to change, make it a bit more SavageJS-like by going to the menu, going to settings, and changing the navigation bar. And here you can see the main menu in portrait mode. We disable this. We only want to have tabs. We want to have the go back button. And that is basically it. You can change some other things like loading images and setting up a search engine here. If you click on here, can see there are various different search engines that you can choose from. DuckDuckGo is by default activated. We can go back, and now you can see the bar, the navigation bar, looks a lot like the SavageJS bar that you have in the SavageJS browser or WebCat. And I can go to tabs if I'd like to, and I also have the option to go to the submenu page here, which allows me to do certain actions on the page, like find something on the page, share the page, add to home screen, which I think will not work, add bookmark, refresh the page, show the desktop site, or hide the navigation bar. But how do I go to settings now? Because the swipe from the right do nothing. So what you can do is just hold and press and hold here and then swipe from the right, and then it will let the menu in and allows you to go to private mode, see your bookmarks, for example, or open up tabs, which is not necessary if you have them down here in the bottom, and go to settings. So if you have to change the settings, you can reach them like this. And as you can see here, modern browsing support. I also can go to a YouTube website, for example, and you can see this is how it looks like when I have to enter something in the browser. Here all the bookmarks or suggestions would appear, and let me just enter youtube.com, and as you can see here, already found it also in the history, browser history. And here I have now the option to just also click on some videos, and it can play YouTube videos. You have the option to go to full screen as well, and it will go to full screen. So it will work quite nicely, as you can see here. And you have the option to choose the different resolutions. And as you can see here, it can go up to 1080p. Hit OK. And it will play it back. So this is pretty nice. So this is the Angelfish web browser, a pretty modern web browser, one of the modernest web browser that you can get currently on SavageJS. And if you have questions, you can ask them in the comments section. And this is everything for this little video. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Until the next time. Bye.